People have been doing mic checks since 1876, when the microphone was invented as part of the telephone. Microphones convert sound to an electronic signal that can be transmitted. If you have something to say, you'll need a microphone to broadcast it. 1-2. 1-2, 1-2. From the glory days of radio to stage, screen and computers, the microphone has always been an essential piece of kit. To make a broadcast quality microphone, they start with a support piece. Automated tools carve a brass cylinder to the desired dimensions. They also make a retainer ring for the microphone grille that will anchor the grille's metal mesh. They layer three sheets of mesh and align them. Then they solder the sheets together. A punch press forms the soldered mesh into a concave shape. They lower a blade to slice the shaped mesh in half. The two pieces will be used to make one microphone grille. An assembler squeezes solder paste into a groove in the brass ring. Then he presses the grille halves, which have been joined by a bracket, into the solder-coated ring. On a carousel, a torch heats the rings and the solder paste melts to bond grills and rings together. A drill punctures a brass disc up to 90 times to make ventilation holes. Another tool levels the surface and shaves off unwanted bits. This disc will be the backplate for one of the microphone's capsules. An assembler brushes away any remaining shavings and then fixes the backplate in a holding device. This plastic membrane has been coated with gold to conduct electricity. She places the membrane and a plastic ring on the backplate and then attaches an electrical lead. She screws the plastic ring down to secure the assembly and then trims away the excess plastic membrane. This microphone capsule is now complete. Next, she'll join two capsules to create the unit that's the heart of the microphone. It converts sound into an electrical signal. An aluminium spacer goes between the capsules, which face back to back. Two capsules instead of one means this microphone can be switched to pick up audio from various directions. A plastic bracket reinforces the assembly. The technician then wires the brass support piece that we saw being made earlier to the electronic system, and then he secures it with screws. After installing switches, he inserts the microphone capsule in the grill. He screws the capsule assembly to the grill and joins it to the electronics. He slides the metal casing over the electronics and secures the microphone with a screw cap. He checks the switch that changes the directionality of the mic, and it's now ready for a sound check. The mic goes into a special anechoic chamber. A computer measures its response to various audio frequencies and directions. Once a microphone has passed this test and some other checks, it's time to pack it up with great care, because this mic is delicate and worth thousands of pounds. Treated properly, this microphone should last several decades. In showbiz, that's some career. Certainly longer than mine. Oh, sorry. Is the microphone switched on?